Sorry, guys. Excuse me. Oh no. It's summoning sick. But yeah, steal we I should have steal the fairy stolen the fairy before my untap so that the fairy rogue would be untapped, right? Stealing it during his turn. Well, no, it's still untapped. Million says, "Oh my god, no." You're right, I was supposed to take the fairy. Oh no, it's still lethal. Yeah, because he's taking one. Just take the fairy and you swing. But I still think we should have end step taken the fairy. I guess not tapping mana there postures that we have something I didn't have. Spawn sleep. You know, that should be the next emote, SketchUp. SketchUp, I have a new emote idea I'm going to share with you guys right after this. Yeah, no, we can't steal it now. Just hit him. He has to have, like, disfigured something. Chalice to get to Batterskull. Wouldn't shackles be better? Where shackles? Ditch the combo. Yeah, I mean, like, that's another thing. Somebody wanted to test me to test the chalice, but this could still just be the third. Oops. This could still. Come on, Magic Online. This could still just be. There we go. This chalice could still just be the third shackles. It still could just be shackles. There you go. Now it's working. It could just be the shackles. Yeah. This spine cleek. That does it. Look for a bolt. Roast. Roast does not deal with Mistbind Cleeked Flies. Actually, why did we leave this in? The only non-flyers of fairy runs is maybe sideboard. Well, they do sometimes sideboard in there we go. How many times have I seen people die to their own? He's not going to. He's going to Mistbind his Bitter Blossom. It's a trick we've seen before. Mistbind Cleek makes him live because he takes the Bitter Blossom, then he'll block the Snapcaster. It does a lot, actually, Structure Mole. Mistbind Cleek does a lot. You see? It does do a lot. What can we get with this West? Just a big old dude, right? Yes, we can just take the 4/4. I actually like doing it now. Any bigger artifacts you want to cheat out instead of just Batterskull? Not really. Again, we've got a Torp. Like, the point of the possibilities isn't really the Batterskull. That Batterskull is plan B. Well, that's cheesy. Batterskull is plan B. But no, it's like, you usually just hit a Shackles, Million. Or, Dino Ahri. But really, what you want to do with the Storm is just this, man. Trust me. This is what you want to be doing instead. You really just want to Emrakul people game one or Blood Moon them. Like, really, what the deck does is you moon them or you, you know. Like, but does that make sense? Plan Batterskull. Worm Coil. No, the Spell Snare. Spell Snare. I don't think I'm supposed to spend the Cryptic there. I mean, yes, he gives him one more turn, but I just, he's shown us like a million soft pieces of soft permission. He can block. It's fine. I'll get over it. This also gives us another turn to posture on this lighthouse or sit on this cryptic. Posture. Come, posture. Composure? Posturing. Alright, he's got a double black spell. It's gonna be sweet. Never mind. I was excited for a second. I was like, oh man, double black does something. Damnation! No! And bitters, yes, alright, what else is this guy doing? So, did we board correctly? I don't think we did. Do I get the Bitter Blossom if he dies? Oh, if Cleek dies under my possession? That's a good question. I don't think so. But that's a good question. Now, like this for this matchup, I really wish we did have the third Shackles. Like, I really do. Unfortunately, I discarded that Pact of Negation, so the cat's out of the bag. He knows about it now. Yeah, we gotta take the roasts out. That was just terrible. I just didn't realize it at the time. Sorry. Do you think he brings in Spell Sky? Chattering Spree might be useful. Wish there were lands to get more mana. Went together, sounds like fun. I mean, he has more one drops than we do, right? I mean, you could argue the Chalice, although the Bolts, I feel like, are just so important in the matchup. You could run Spell Scat, I guess. I don't know. I mean, Chalice isn't completely nothing. It does ramp us, and we are trying to do some really big mana things. I feel like we really still need to at least test some more games with this card. The Chalice. Okay, so I've got room for one more. You could leave in one Possibility Storm because of the Teferi Possibilities lock. It locks my opponent out of the game. In our deck, technically, we get better rolls, technically, because this deck has things like Mana Leak. I technically get better Possibility Dice rolls. Does that make sense? You can run one Possibility when you bring in the Teferi. This hand seems solid, but he's probably just going to, you know, duress the crap out of it, or Inquisition, or Thoughtseize. Probably Inquisition Thoughtseize, but I'll keep it. He'll take Moon, but we still have an Anger and Explosives. Artifact plus Spine of Ishsa. If he had it, he probably would have turn 1'd it. Right? If he had it, he probably would have turn 1'd it. Wouldn't he? Million Little says, run the Seize Claims. I don't really like them in the grindy matches, but I'm with you. Yes, Possibility Storm. Think of the possibilities, man. You know, I might actually want to make one of these a land drop. And you guys might be sitting there like, why? Well, sometimes you do actually make these as a land drop. You can pick them up later with Cryptic and then reuse them for Transmutation, but sometimes you really want to make those land drops. Ambush Viper? Go for it, man. Do it. Do it. Do the Ambush Viper. Inquisition. Okay, he'll take Blood Moon. But he also is going to see why I kept this hand. I think it was solid. You gotta take the Moon, man. No? Maybe not. Possibility Storm plus Artifact into Blightsteel. Blightsteel's not that cheap, though, is he? I'm talking money-wise. The nice thing about the Batterskull is it's pretty decent in the meta, and you can actually just hardcast it even if you're not trying to possibilities into it. Million says, I still think a second possibility was better than the first Everflowing Chalice. That's reasonable. Seriously, though, with this hand, I wouldn't mind doing a little bit of ramp. I don't know, let's test that theory. Why don't I go grab the, why don't I Talaria West into the Everflowing, and we'll see if the ramp matters. It's just a practice match, man. Like, this is the place to do it. If we're all convinced that the West is, the West into Chalice play for two sucks, then, like, we'll just have to cut it, probably turn it back into another copy of Shackles. Because that was the idea when we needed it, like, when we were like, man, we just need a little more mana. Transmute for this, and then next turn, kick it twice. This might be the last time we test it, though. If we're just not impressed with it, then yes, we'll just cut it. I don't know, somebody really wanted me to test it. When you guys really want me to test cards, I'll do it. You know, that's kind of my show. Endless Sworn is the replacement for Memnite. Yes, it lets you run artifacts. Fun with sounds. And artifacts are actually really good in this deck. You can run everything from Vedakin Shackles to Batterskull to Spellskites to Chalice, Torpor Orb. You get to run a lot of utility because of Endless One, Fun with Sounds. That's why it's called Endless Possibilities. No, we changed the name because somebody didn't like it. They wanted me to call it Bloodstorm. Like, Endless Possibilities is kind of cool, actually. Kind of like the Endless Possibilities, not going to lie. I still do, guys. I still like that. I still like Endless Possibilities more, but whatever. Endless One's always on curve. Yeah, some games you'll just tutor it. Like, against Affinity, this guy blocks Etch Champion for days. You just make a big old Endless One. Memnite can't do that. Ornithopter can't do that. Well, I mean, they can block it, but they won't block it for days. Let's try it. You want to counter my Everflowing Chalice? Multi-kick. Multi-kick for two. Okay. Wow, they changed a lot about... I don't ever remember the multi-kick looking like that. Okay. Foma Sound says you like the sound of Endless Possibilities. Endless Possibilities is still the better deck name? I think so, too. Where were we with the deck? Hang on. We had made several... let's just put it back on what number it's supposed to be. So we were on 1.6. This is version 1.6. Because the possibilities are endless, guys. We have endless possibilities. I feel like Chalice might just want to be another land, as insane as that sounds. And see, now we realize it does suck. Oh, you want me to run 27? I feel like 26 is still fine. You think we're supposed to run 27 land? Fun sounds says Chalice is less good now that Eldrazi is the popular thing. No, we actually already cut it. I said this was probably the last game we test this. I already cut it in the list, guys. It's already the third Shackles. So go. Is he gonna tech catch me here? It's actually not bad for us if he does. Snapcaster Inquisition? That's bad for us. He'll take the Anger of the Gods. Right? I imagine that's what he's taking, if he's committing creatures to the table. Although this Explosives answers both his creatures, too. Well, he really shouldn't take Anger, because I might snap Anger, actually, if he does. But I'd still... I kind of want to hold the Explosives. Bitter Blossom is a concern. He tanks the Anger. Yeah, I could totally just snap Anger. I can't ignore his threats forever. Like, him taking Anger makes me think he... Oh, wow, we just drew the endless one. Makes me think he wants to try to... that's actually more reason to just go for the snap Anger play. Show me Spell Snare. It's got to be a Spell Snare mission. I mean, I can't ignore these threats. And actually, the Engineered Explosives is safer on the table than it is in my hand in this matchup for multitude of reasons. He's blue-black. That's the major reason. His color combination. This is safer on the table than it's in my hand. Just realized the reason Eldrazi wins is that they prepared for the meta. The meta was not prepared. I feel dumb for realizing that only just now. Bobby says getting the 5 was the issue. Think you're fine using any other card. Okay. Well, it's because the West you kind of have to hold. So, like, in reality, it's really only 22. But, like, the first West I see, I've been less nervous about playing out. Could just slam a big endless one. Also, like, loot housing and see what he does. Maybe he'll spend some time going for the tech edge. Maybe he'll spend some time trying to, we'll see. Eldrazi wins in all but the most hateful of metas. So you think his three cards are... It's probably Bitter Blossom, right? Bitter Blossom, Bitter Blossom, Bitter Blossom. Just waiting for me to pop the explosives. Now we can get the explosives back.
Just try to burn your shape. It's too slow.
Ensnaring Burn? That sounds cool, Tame.